Sometimes when you're running Terraform, an organization might have existing resources that are living in the cloud that were configured maybe through the console or other infrastructure as code products, and you want to bring those under the umbrella of management of Terraform. Did you know that you could do that with Terraform Import? Well, guess what? In this video, you'll learn how to do that and some of the gotchas of doing that, making sure you don't delete your resources in the process. Watch this video that I've recorded from my course Terraform 101, Certified Terraform Associate. Enjoy it and leave me any comments in the comments section below. Hi, welcome back. In this lecture, we're going to talk about Terraform Import and see how that all works. Let's get started. Okay, back to Visual Studio Code, and now we're also in section 3 and in lab 4. And once again, we have our guide and we have our main.tf file. The main.tf file is very similar to what we saw before. Nothing has changed except this block here that we're going to uncomment, and I'll talk about that in just a few minutes. So back to our guide. Let's first talk about Terraform Import and what that is and where is it needed. So suppose an engineer on your team decided to create an EC2 instance in AWS's console directly, not using Terraform. So they went in, they clicked, they created the EC2 instance. Now Terraform doesn't know anything about it. Why? Because it's not stored in its state file, because Terraform didn't create it. So you may have an EC2 instance that Terraform created and one that your fellow engineer created through the console. Now, is there a way to bring that EC2 instance that your colleague created under the umbrella of Terraform's management? And the answer is yes. That's what Terraform Import does. Okay, and you can see the documentation here. And let's take a look. And here it is, the import. And it opened twice. So in here, you can see one important aspect, current state only. The current implementation of Terraform Import can only import resources into the state file. It does not generate the configuration. And it says a future version of Terraform will also generate configuration. So we're waiting on that to happen. But for now, the Terraform Import command only brings the resource into the state file. You have to manually create the configuration, because if you don't create the configuration and run Terraform apply, Terraform doesn't see the configuration, it's going to remove it from the state file and even remove it from AWS's console as well. So that's why you really have to create the configuration so that Terraform knows that this is correct and that's the configuration, and won't destroy that resource. Okay, good. So first of all, let's recreate that EC2 instance. So we are, make sure we're in the right folder, 04, perfect. Let's run Terraform init. And the sequence of this lab, basically we're gonna create the EC2 instance via Terraform and one via the AWS console to simulate what an engineer might do outside of Terraform, and then bring that EC2 instance into the state file of Terraform and create the configuration inside of the main.tf file so that we can truly import that resource. Okay, good. Now let's apply this. So it's clear Terraform apply auto approve. And while this creates the instance inside of through Terraform, we're going to go ahead and manually create the EC2 instance from the console. And to keep things a little different, I'm going to use an Amazon Linux AMI as opposed to the Ubuntu one that Terraform is creating. And then we're going to import. So let's go ahead and go to our console. Let's just refresh this. These are all terminated and there's one pending that Terraform is creating right now. But I want to launch an instance directly from the AWS console. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, I'm going to leave this as is, and I'm going to leave Amazon Linux selected. That's all fine. T2 Micro, so we're within the free tier. I'm going to proceed without a key pair. Obviously, I don't need that instance. I'm not going to SSH into it or anything like that. create a security group, leave SSH. Everything I'm gonna leave as is and just launch this instance. You can see it's successful. It launched it, so let's view all instances. Looks like the one that Terraform created is running. Let's refresh this. And here's the pending one that has been created through the AWS console. Okay, so it's the bottom one with the 18.205 public IP address. Let's go back to our console. There we have it, the public IP 54.175. That's the one that's under Terraform's management, which is this one here. And you can see the other one is already running. Very good. And to prove to you that Terraform knows nothing about this, I'm going to run Terraform state list. And there you have it. We only know about one AWS instance, one EC2 instance in here. Okay. Now, let's see what we need to do here. Well, first of all, I want you to check the documentation for the import command for AWS instance resource. This is important because every resource is a little different. So it's always very important to reference the documentation for what you're trying to do and how you would import a particular resource. So we're in the documentation here. We have the, we are on the AWS instance within the EC2 Elastic Compute Cloud. And usually the import is at the very bottom. So if you scroll to the very bottom, you'll find the import statement. And it tells you Terraform import AWS instance.web, and then it gives you the ID. So you would import it with the name that you want. AWS instance is constant, you will always use that. .web, this is the arbitrary name that you would name it, and then the actual ID of that instance. So let's go back here, and we are going to need to run this command, Terraform import AWS instance, and we're going to give it a name. I'm going to call it console. Okay, and now we need the instance ID. So we got to go back in here and grab the instance ID, which is this one. Okay, I'm going to copy that. I'm going to go in here and paste it. Okay. And notice what we're getting. Resource address AWS instance.console does not exist in the configuration. Before importing this resource, please create its configuration in the root module. For instance, or for example, resource AWS instance console and some arguments. That is expected because we don't have that configuration. And if you try Terraform plan, let's see what happens. Because this hasn't been imported, it failed to import it. It just sees that there are no changes, right? So now let's go ahead and go to our main.tf file and uncomment this. And by the way, if you click Control/, that can uncomment for you directly within Visual Studio Code. And what we did here is we added a resource similar to this one. So it's AWS instance. We gave it the name console as opposed to that web server one. And the instance type is T2 micro. That's what we created. And the AMI is this AMI, which corresponds to the Amazon Linux AMI. If you're curious where I got that from, if you click on the actual instance here and you start to look for the AMI, you can see it right at the bottom here. So you can copy this and basically paste it here, and that should take care of that for you. Let's save that, Control S, and go back to our terminal, clear, and let's go back and import this. And there you have it, AWS instance console import prepared, import successful. These resources are now in your Terraform state and will henceforth be managed by Terraform. So that's excellent. Now let's go ahead and run a Terraform plan. Clear here, Terraform plan. Okay, refreshing state, refreshing state. We have both the console and web server. Your infrastructure matches the configuration. You can run a Terraform apply, auto approve, just to see this as well. And of course, there are no changes as we saw. So zero added, zero change, zero deployed. And if you want to now check the Terraform state list, you would expect to see two instances. And there you have it, the AWS instance console, which was imported, and the AWS instance web server one, which already existed under Terraform's management. Now, if you run Terraform destroy auto approve, this should now go ahead and destroy both instances. Since now it's under Terraform's management, the console one is under Terraform's management, it's going to go ahead and destroy both. You can see here it says to the destroy, so it will go out and destroy both instances. And we can go take a quick peek here at the two instances. You can see they're shutting down both of the instances, the imported one and also the one that existed from before. And that's it for this lab and lecture. You've learned what Terraform import is, when to use it, how to use it, and what kind of behavior to expect when you're running Terraform import. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture. And that's it. I hope you learned something new today, and you'll go about using Terraform import the right way. But actually, it's even better if you don't have to use Terraform import, and you lock down the provisioning of your environment to always be used through Terraform and nothing other than Terraform. That would be the best way moving forward. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video.